What's up, everybody? Day three of part four of the God Never Said That series. We're unpacking this idea that, well, if it's in the Bible, that means God said it, so the Bible says it, I should believe it, and that settles it. And we're taking a look at this idea of context and how the scriptures in its context is actually a love story. Now, some of you that know your scriptures well, you'd be like, okay, there are times in the Bible when someone does something wrong, like someone clearly screwed up, they disobeyed, whatever. And yet, the entire like community, instead of just punishing or holding that one person accountable, they actually hold accountable and punish the entire family. And sometimes it's an extended family. And I'm sure like right now as you're watching this, you're like, yeah, I can think of stories in the scriptures where that person wasn't just held accountable and punished, but the whole family was held accountable and punished. And you're thinking, how is that a part of a love story? But we have to understand it in its context. And this is what it is. At that time, when we understand and unpack the stories, when someone, you know, screwed up or messed up or whatever, and instead of that person being held accountable, the whole family or a part of the whole community is accountable. The reason is because at that time, at that point in history, justice was understood as communal. If the community wasn't held accountable for that one individual act from that one individual, then in their head and their understanding, that wasn't justice. And you and I, we have a God of justice. Now today, in our world, in our culture, that's not justice. That's something else, totally weird. And that's why it's hard for us to understand, right? So if I screw up and do something, then you're not gonna punish my family, my children, my dogs. You're gonna punish me, because we understand that to be justice. And so ultimately, we have a God of justice, which is a beautiful and powerful thing. It just looks different today for us than it did for them then. So again, when we're reading the scriptures, and this is why I believe it's important to read them, unpack them in a group where you can dialogue and discuss, maybe look at some resources as you go along. But ultimately, the first thing we have to do when we read the scriptures is, what did it mean to them then? And then extrapolate that principle. What does that then mean for us now? Ultimately, the scriptures teach about this God, this God who's madly in love with us, and this is his love story. But justice is important to God. Injustices hurt and pain God. So in that time, justice would happen and it would look and sound like that for them. Please, we can't just say, well, this is what the Bible says, so therefore I believe it, that settles it, and that's how we apply it. No, we can't do that. Ultimately, what is the principle? We have a God of justice and love, and that's gonna look different for us today. Hopefully that makes sense. If you have any questions, comments, whatever, maybe reactions, maybe you're angry, maybe you think I'm wrong, cool. Text, email, call, be happy to dialogue with you as we unpack the scriptures, apply them today, and truly try to dance with God.